Bunyoro Kitara Kingdom has joined other kingdoms in agitating for the return of its property after government gave Uganda the Ebiafe.
Bunyoro, you can see that file there.
The Attorney General Peter Nyombi says government plans to hand over the KMPC and the Kyangwali land titles.
But we started with two properties. One property is at a place called Kyangwali. Another property is at a place called KMPC. These are large, large tracts of land.
Swaths of Kyangwali land in Hoima district currently serves as a refugee settlement camp. Since the discovery of oil and gas in Bunyoro sub-region, the kingdom has been demanding for royalties when production begins.
The constitution is very clear about that. They can claim the surface rights, but the minerals belong to the state. It's very clear in the constitution.
In Buganda, some lawmakers have commissioned a study on the recently returned properties.
We are still ready to make sure that if there is more verification we need, actually it will be done.
However, there are fears that many of the properties have squatters.
Of course, some people have come to say this was a real answer. We are given land titles, we actually don't have land. The land which was given, it's already occupied by the people. This might be true, but land remains land.
So in effect, the people of Uganda cannot be shortchanged that simply by simple people saying we are that gullible. We can easily be lied to.
These properties were grabbed by the central government during the Obote I regime after he abolished kingdoms in 1966. It's quite difficult to locate these properties.
For example, go to Mukono, where Sekibobo sits. It is supposed to be 80 kilometers across. Virtually the whole of bigger part of Mukono town has been leased to private owners on that land.
It was agreed that the people who have settled on the land were not going to be evicted.
So that was a heap of paper, effectively, good as it may be, just a cavera which was without anything in it.
Some of the land titles that were returned to Buganda Kingdom from the central government have since been occupied by sub-county headquarters and district headquarters, as well as courts of law, like this one. However, the Attorney General says they will have to go into negotiation with the Buganda Kingdom to solve the matter.
Probably the Kabaka may opt to lease those properties to the government. It is something that can be sorted out.
They were never built for rent. These are not rent houses for Buganda to earn money out of them. These were structures that were supposed to deliver services to the people.
However, regime critics view the return of the properties as a ploy to gain leverage in kingdoms ahead of the 2016 polls.
That's what I put to the Prime Minister. That's what I put to anybody in government, to really go out of his way and explain to the people of Uganda what exactly was returned.
Even if we are to gain politically out of the handing over of the properties, I see nothing wrong. Everybody would like that. But we followed the law. There is a law.
Some of these land titles are Nibururi and Bugerere, areas that have demanded for autonomy from Buganda.
The administrative units that had been set up by the Kabaka in Nibururi or Bugerere should be left to those people. So the people in Nibururi will not be dispossessed. Those two places, it was agreed in the agreement, because the titles are in the names of the Kabaka. And there is no way you can transfer those titles unless the Kabaka signs the transfers. So that is going to be done.
Toro has also demanded for the return of its properties. Even at a time the Ankore Kingdom lies in abeyance, the trustees want what belongs to them returned. Jingo Francis, NTV Weekend Edition.